Hi everyone, welcome to our new video. Today we're going to show you how to fix one of the errors in one of the most disturbing errors in Spring Boot, where when I try to run this application of mine, which I just started, like I find a disturbing issue here, which says failed to configure a data source URL distribute is not specified and not embedded data source. No embedded data source could be configured. Reason: failed to determine a suitable driver class. Right? The simple is simple. So when we were building this, I told Spring Boot that I need to use mysql database. Then the stress is I did not give it that information, so we're gonna see how to fix that. Anyway, this gonna be, you can see source, this folder, when I do it. Okay, if I do this, look for the folder called this other source. Sometimes it could be in something else. You may be using Eclipse or using a different IDE. I'm using NetBeans, but still it's gonna be the same thing. So you go and look for your, let me look for default packages, then you look for application.properties. There you double click. We're gonna start typing the code which gonna help us to fix the issue. So which means you have to connect to MySQL, giving the information about that. So that's the reason why you find that issue. So you're gonna type in here spring.datasource. You can even control and take your control space bar, then you say enter. Then I'm sure you can go and delete this datasource.url. Okay, then you say it's gonna be equals to, then there you're gonna give what they call JDBC drivers. JDBC, you can, there's no suggestion there. You can say then JDBC is gonna be MySQL, then /, /, localhost, right? Okay. Once you have that in place, you're gonna put the port number. I don't know what port number you're using, but the default one is 3306. Then say /, then you give what they call the database name. This is my database name. DB. Then you go down on the second page, you say spring dot data source, dot, it's gonna be dot what, username, it's gonna be username. Then you give the username for your database. It's gonna be admin. Mine, I've made it admin. Some of you, it could be root or whatever. Then you go down and say spring dot data source dot password, right? That's gonna be password. Then you say equals to your password admin. Well, I made some mistake here. Up, this should be equal sign. It must be equal sign. Yes, once we're done with those, you can as well create this line. Let me see, there's a line here which is gonna be here. this line says spring dot jpa dot dot hibernate okay ddl dash auto, so that can help you to create what a table automatically. So you can create or you can update or whatever. So I'm gonna say update table. I'll just leave it like that. Well, that's fine. I'm sure this can help us. This first line, it also fixes one of the errors, major issues. If you don't put it, you make sure that the port 8080 does not have any service running on that, because if it does, Spring Boot won't run because it's gonna find someone is already using that. You get me? So I use this port to just put server.port equals to 8081 just to avoid any conflict on that. Well, that's super fine. So what's gonna go on now? I'm gonna run my application. What I do, okay, you have to go here and save. You can see the application before you run it. You can see down here, you can really see there is that message, the one you have, that nonsense message. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go back here, my application, and I run. Still running. Build was successful, right? We didn't see that message, but now there's some issue we have, small issue. This, I don't know if Spring can do a pop-up. It didn't do that. It say error, starting application to display the condition report, run your application with debug enable. Okay, leave that. What we're gonna do, I'm gonna disable this. This could be the issue now, because I'm trying to display J option pen. I leave it, then I'm gonna run the application to display just on the console. Okay, I want this to say I win this time. Once you see that message, you just know that we won, really. Finished, and let me see if we can see any issues or no issues. We have that which we not supposed to see. But the old message is gone. Okay, you can see we don't see that old message anymore. But still, I have to make you be happy. I'm gonna go back here and see where did I go wrong here. MySQL, let me see. I'm gonna copy the code and paste it there. Maybe I did something and I don't want to waste a lot of time for you. Paste that. Okay, once I pasted that, you can save. Okay, you can see I can put the code in the description below for you to just copy and paste. Okay, let me run my application again. I need to see this. I win this time. It was successful, but I still can't see the message. Okay. Oh, that I understand. You know what happens here is the port 81 Springboard is using, it's already running, so we have to stop it. You get me? So we stop that, we stop that, right? So let me see, start. Okay, we can also do it easily. Okay, I was amazed and say, why is it not working? So it should work. I can even put it 82. Okay, then we go back here and we start application. Let's use it. Okay, let's do this. Fine. Run. Programming, it needs patience. You must be patient. Ladies and gents, that worked. 82 was already used, so don't worry about that. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna close the application. Okay, exit. Yes, after closing it, give it few seconds so that we want to close those ports. Then I go, I run it again. Well, that's good. I'm gonna click here. Still compiling. Okay. Other sources. We go here. Okay. Go to this. Wanna give it 81 again. 81. Okay, then we save. We go back here. I'm gonna start our application. Ladies and gents, we won. You can see what it tells us. It says, I win this time. Well, that's good. So it gives you some trouble. Restart it because of the ports. You get me? Remember what I told you when I was starting here? I said, when the port is occupied, your application is not going to work. But our argument here, the reason why the application was not working because of this, only these four lines, if you put in your four lines, you good to go. You understand? So that's it, guys. Thanks for watching. If it worked for you, subscribe, comment, share. Two, you can ask more questions about this. I'm gonna make sure you get the code. Check into the description below. You will see the code if you can't see them on the screen. Well, thanks for watching and see you in the next video.